Dear students, see last time in lesson number 10, we studied about gravitation, okay? We talked about density also and relative density. Now today we start a new lesson, okay, that is work and energy. See, this is in continuation with our kinematics, okay? See, that includes a linear motion, rectilinear motion, laws of motion, and see the work and energy. Now see, the work has some specific meaning, okay? Work has some specific meaning in the language of science, or we say especially in physics, okay? Suppose someday your friend come to you and tell you, let us say, let us go to movie, but you see, you know that your sir or teacher has given a lot of homework, okay? 4, 5, 6, 7 hours, you try to complete it sitting at one place, okay? At the end of the day, you are exhausted. Oh, I have done a lot of work today. But in that case, suppose you have not moved from your place, see, the work done is not zero. Work done is zero, okay? In physics, work has some specific meaning, okay? That we have to see in this lesson. Now, see, generally it is divided into two parts. See, first is a work done by constant force, and work done by variable force. Now see, all these lessons, see the kinematics, that is the motion in a straight line, Newton's laws of motion and work energy are with the same name you study in the 11th standard also. That's why I feel it is very important for you. Now see, in our scope, in our textbook, we have to study the work done by the constant force only. Now let us say, see, a block is lying stationary. See, we start with a simple thing, we consider it a smooth surface, that is the F is a force. Okay, F is a force. Now, let us say it is displaced by D. Okay, let us say it is displaced by D. Okay, so work is force into displacement. See, what we say, the body is displaced by D in direction of force. So we can write in the statement like this. Let us say, block is subjected to force F as shown in figure. See, it is displaced by D in direction of force. Then we can write, work is force into displacement. Okay? See, the block is lying on a surface. Initially, we assume that it is a smooth surface, so we can neglect the friction. Okay? Or we do not have to account to the friction part. So then work, our task will be easy. So let us say the block is subjected to force F. So it is displaced by D in the direction of force. So the work is force into displacement. Okay, now let us say we take a simple example that can be asked. Okay. Let us say the block is subjected to 50 Newton force. Okay, now see, it is displaced by 4 meter in the direction of force. Then work is force into displacement. See, what is the value of force here? 50 Newton. Displacement is 4. Okay. Now, see, what will be the unit of work? See, what is the unit of force which is known to us? Newton. And displacement is in meter. Newton meter. Okay. So the work then is 200 Newton meter. Now, see, in honor of the scientist James Joule, Newton meter is called Joule. Joule. Okay? Now, Joule is a unit of energy. Now, we know very well to do any work, we require energy. Okay? So, that is how the work and energy are related to each other. Okay? Or we can say 1 Newton meter is 1 Joule. Now, see, we come across different unit systems. See, in MPS unit system, unit is Joule. And CGS system, the unit of work is Arg. Okay? Now, later on, we'll study how to establish the relation between Joule and Arg. Now, what we have seen here? Here we have done, assume that the force is constant. Okay? And the displacement is in the direction of force. But let us say, consider a situation in which, see, the force and displacement are not in the same direction. See, we take a simple example. Let us say when you are very small, okay, now you used to play with some this card, okay, now which was, okay, you have to carry like this, okay, see, it was moving like this. See, what we see here, the force is applied at some angle, okay. Now see, the cart was to move in this direction, okay. Let us say it is inclined at angle theta, okay. See, what we see here, the force and displacement. Now see, the displacement is horizontal. See, the force is inclined to cart. What we see, the force and displacement are not in the same direction. Now we have to see how we can calculate the work. Okay? So, here also the force is constant. Okay? But, see, force is inclined at angle. Okay? Let us say theta. So, we can say when force and displacement are not in same direction. Okay? Let us say block, okay, is subjected to force F at angle theta. Here also we consider a smooth surface, okay, so we can neglect the friction. Now let us say the displacement of the block, okay, is B, okay. Now let force F is subjected at angle theta. Okay? Let block is subjected force at angle theta. Okay, now see, more force is a vector quantity. See, later on we will study in the 11th standard. Now see, the force can be divided into two parts. See, force F, theta is the angle. See, the component of the force in the direction of displacement is F cos theta. Okay? Component of force in the direction of displacement is theta. Okay? Now, we can write like this. The block is subjected to force F at angle theta. Let block is displaced by B in direction of force, in horizontal direction. Okay? Now see, the component of force in the direction of displacement is F cos theta. Component of force in direction of okay. See, here the block is subjected to force F at angle theta. See, in the horizontal direction, see, the displacement of the block is D. Now, this force, as I told, is a vector quantity. It can be divided into two components, F cos theta, that is in the direction of the horizontal direction, okay, and second is F sin theta. Okay, so what we can see, the component of the force in the direction of displacement is F cos theta. Okay, then work done is the component of force in direction of okay, so we can write this as F cos theta into D F D cos theta. So this is how we can say the force and displacement are not in same direction. So when the force and displacement are not in the same direction, see, work done we can calculate by taking the component of the force in the direction of displacement. Okay, that is F cos theta we have seen, and D is a displacement. So work done is F D cos theta. Now see, the work is a scalar quantity. Okay, work can be positive. Okay, work is a scalar quantity. Okay, that we have to keep in mind. Now, so this is how we can calculate the work done by a constant force. First, we have seen when force and displacement are in the same direction. Secondly, we have seen when force and the displacement are not in the same direction. Okay, now when force and the displacement are in opposite direction, then work done we have to consider negative. Okay, now see, initially in our discussion part we have excluded friction, or we can say we neglected friction. Now let us say the rough surface like this. Now this is a notation generally, or a method we represent when, see, there is a friction between two surfaces. Now see, again the block is displaced by subjected to force F. See, it is displaced by D. But here we have to consider friction also in account. Okay. Now, as we discussed earlier, frictional force is always in opposite direction of the motion. Okay. So work done. See, the displacement is in the right hand direction, we can see, and the frictional force is in opposite direction. So here force and displacement are in opposite direction, then work done we have to consider negative. So when force and displacement are in opposite direction, work done is considered okay. See, when force and displacement are in opposite direction, okay, work done is considered negative. See, the frictional force is a good example of this. See, in that case we can see the work done by the frictional force we have to consider always negative. Okay, so this is about the case when the force and displacement are not in the same direction. Okay, now see, next we have to see about kinetic energy. Okay, all of you are aware by the word na, kinetic. You read, see, tamar bike nu naam chhe, see, Activa, kinetic Honda. So the word kinetic, you know, has to do with the motion. Kinetic has to do with the motion. So what is kinetic energy? See, the energy possessed by body by virtue of of its motion is called energy possessed by body by virtue of motion is called kinetic energy. Simple example, see tamai you are standing on a terrace, you drop a stone on your friend downstairs, okay, on the ground, and it falls on its hand. You can see lot of doers work is done. Okay, so now see your moving ball has a kinetic energy. Okay, now just now you see the watch the IPL, see the when the ball is hit hard by the batsman, see it possess kinetic energy. So a moving body has kinetic energy, that is energy possessed by body by virtue of its motion is called kinetic energy. Now let us see how it has to some relation with the work. Okay, now we try to derive the equation of a kinetic energy. Okay, now we have seen, see the energy possessed by body by virtue of its motion is called kinetic energy. Now let us say again the block is subjected to force F. Let us say mass of the block is M. Let mass of block is M. Here also we consider smooth surface. Okay, so we can neglect the friction. Okay, now it is subjected to force F. Okay, as shown in figure. Now let us say the block is displaced by D, okay, in direction of a force. Okay, the block is displaced by D in the direction of force. Now see work done is force into displacement. Now see our Newton's laws of motion, second law, F is equal to ma is known to us. Okay, now what you can see, work is mad, mad, but it is not like that. If you do not work, you will go mad. Okay, otherwise it will keep you active. Now see work done is force into displacement. Now see by Newton's second law of motion, okay, F is equal to ma, so if I substitute it is mad. So see, I just rearrange M into AD. Now see, recall our equation of motion with the constant acceleration or uniform acceleration. There is D is equal to V square minus V0 square upon 2. Okay, now this we derived earlier in lesson number 8. See, the this is a kinematic equation of motion with a constant acceleration. See, the D is the displacement, V0 is the initial velocity, V is the final velocity, A is our acceleration. So now if I take A on left hand side, AD has become V square minus V0 square upon 2. Okay, now W is MAD that we have rearranged. See, if I substitute this value, M into V square minus V0 square by 2. Okay, that is 1 by 2 mv square minus. Okay, now see, v0 is the initial velocity here, v is the final velocity. Now if I assume initially body at rest, that is v0 is 0, so then it will become half mv square. Why? Because if initial velocity is 0, this term will become 0. Now see, this work is done because of the motion or a moving body. Now see, that's why we can say a body in motion possesses kinetic energy. Now see, the symbol for kinetic energy is K, or sometimes it is called KE. So this K is equal to KE kinetic energy is half mv square. So remember the formula for the kinetic energy, E is equal to half mv square. Okay, now Kinetic energy is the energy possessed by body by virtue of its motion. So, see, we can say half of the product of m is the mass of the body, v square is the square of the velocity, is called kinetic energy. So, we can write like this, half of product of mass and square of velocity. So, kinetic energy equation we have to remember, K is equal to half mv square. Okay? Now, half of the product of mass and square of the velocity is called kinetic energy. Now, so kinetic energy is the energy possessed by a body by virtue of its motion. Now, see in the ninth lesson, that is laws of motion, we studied about momentum. Now see, what is momentum? Momentum is product of mass and velocity. Okay, now V is the velocity, kinetic energy equation is K is equal to half mv square. So, let us try to derive the relation between kinetic energy and momentum. Now, see our equation, K is equal to half mv square. Now, see here, P is equal to mv. So, we can call P square is m square v square. Okay, we have taken square on both sides. Now, here it is 1 by 2 mv square. I want m square here, suppose. So, what I do? Multiply and divide by m. So, we can write as 1 by 2. M square v square and m. Okay, so we have multiply by and divided by m. Now see, our this m square v square is p square. Okay, so k is equal to p square by 2m. So this is a relation between, okay, kinetic energy and momentum. Relation or in other word we can write P square is equal to 2km, P is equal to under root 2km, P is momentum, 2 is constant, K is kinetic energy and is the m is the mass of the object. Okay, so this is about the relation between kinetic energy and momentum. Now see, so far, see what we have done, see the work done by the constant force. In the first case we saw, see, the force and displacement were in the same direction. And second case, see, the force is inclined. Okay, now we take example based on this. Okay, now let us say our example number 11.1. Okay, now see, a force of 5 Newton is subjected to a body. See, the block is displaced by 2 meters in the direction of the force. Okay, see what is the work done. So work done, see the block is like this, let us say. Okay, force is F is 5 meters. Let us say the block is displaced by 2 meters. So here we can say work done is F is 5 into 10 newton meter or 10 g. Okay, so this is about example number 11.1. see, the force is 5 newton, displacement given is 2 meter, work done is product of force and, okay. Now, see, we take the example number 11.2, okay. Now, see, a porter okay, you know, he carries a luggage. See, a 15 kg luggage, mass is 15 kg, okay, height of 1.5 meter. Okay. Yeah. okay, above the ground, what is the work done by the luggage. Okay, now see here, the body is lifted like this. So what is the force acting? Is a gravitational force. Okay, here the force acting is a gravitational force. Now see, mg is our gravitational force. So here work is done by the gravitational force. Instead of d, if I can write h, because it is height. Okay, f is mg. Okay, mgh. Now see here, mass is 15. Now see g, gravitational acceleration, we take 10 meter per second square for calculation. Okay, so when a porter carries a luggage to a height of 1.5 meter, see the mass of the luggage is 15 kg, see the work done is 225 kg. Okay, so this is about example number 11.2. Now, next is example number 11.3. Okay, now see an object of mass 15 kg moving with a uniform velocity. What is the kinetic energy? Okay, now see, as we have talked, see the energy possessed by body by virtue of its motion is kinetic energy. See, kinetic energy K, dl is the formula, we know the formula, half mv square, mass is 15, velocity is 2 square. Okay, so when a block of body of mass 15 kg moves with a uniform velocity of 4 meter per second, see the energy is, kinetic energy is 30 joule. Okay, okay, here it is 4, no, sorry. Okay, so then we have to simplify. See here, velocity is 4, instead of by mistake 2. Now let us say calculate again. Okay, 15 into 30, 4 is 120. So this is how we can calculate the kinetic energy. See the formula of the kinetic energy, we have to remember, kinetic energy is half mv square. Now, so this is about example number 11.3. Now let us say example number 11.4. Okay, now see, work done to increase the velocity of car of mass 1500 kg. Okay, see the initial velocity V0 is 30 km per hour, 2, final velocity is 60 km per hour. Now, see the MKS unit of velocity is meter per second. Now, we have to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, that can be easily done by formula. See, kilometer per hour into 10 upon 36 is meter per second. So, V0. Okay, 300. Okay, now see the kinetic energy is 1/2. Here we have to calculate change in kinetic energy. Okay, delta K is K2 minus K1 or K2 minus K0 also, 1/2 m. V square minus, you can write V2 and V1 and V and V0, but generally initial velocity we call as V0 and the final velocity is this. So 1/2 m V square minus V0 square. See the mass is 1500, velocity, final velocity is, okay, initial velocity is 300. Okay, now see, we have to simplify. Okay, that is 156. ओके सी डू नॉट वरी ऑफ द लार्जर कैलकुलेशन के लाइक दिस सी इन एग्जाम विल गिव द वैल्यूज विच आर कंपेरेटिवली ईजी सपोज इंस्टेड आई गिव 60 इफ आई गेट 36 किलोमीटर पर आवर देन आई गेट 54 और 72 किलोमीटर सी योर वर्क विल बी ईजी सो हियर सी द चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द कार ऑफ मास 100 kg इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज 30 किलोमीटर पर आवर सी दैट वी हैव टू कन्वर्ट इन मीटर पर सेकंड के बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग विद 10 एंड डिवाइड बाय 36 सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी सी द यूनिट विल बी जूल काइनेटिक एनर्जी यूनिट इज ओके सो द चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी आल्सो विल बी नाउ सो दिस इज अबाउट द वर्क डन और चेंज इन द काइनेटिक एनर्जी नाउ सी व्हाट इज काइनेटिक एनर्जी एनर्जी पजेस्ड by body by virtue of its motion is called kinetic energy now today we have seen what is work as I told you work has some specific meaning in the language of physics in physics or in science see work is said to be done only when the body is displaced by force maybe in direction of the force maybe in the opposite direction okay so we saw work done by constant force Okay, first case we saw when the force and displacement are in the same direction. Okay, in second case we saw that the force is inclined or it is applied at some angle. Then also we can calculate the work. Okay, then we talked about kinetic energy. That is a energy possessed by body by virtue of motion is called kinetic energy. See a moving ball has a kinetic energy. See the flowing water has kinetic energy. You studied later on. We studied different form of the energy also. We also see, we'll see how one form of the energy is converted in the another form. Okay, so this is all about today. See, next time we'll proceed in the lesson number 11, work energy. Thank you.